Let's see, I'm on the play again. Yeah, this hand's still fine. Seems every time I draft Lust for War, I end up with, like, end up drawing it, like, every single game. Alright. Sure. Knight of Cliffhaven, huh? I think we want to get the Law of Human Voker out here. Make him spend his time leveling something. Funny thing is, he might have been a point short last time if I didn't have Vendetta. So it's pretty sweet if he's kicking himself, you know, thinking that he could have won if he only didn't get Vendetta'd. I'd rather just trade, and I'm going to heat raise guy instead of Lust for Warring, I think. Yeah, that's not going to happen. I'll take a little bit of damage off this caravan escort, I suppose. Time of Heroes is pretty filthy. Land? Ooh, not land at all. Alright, well, time to race then. Need to draw land pretty fast here. Especially if he's got more guys. Well, that's not, I guess, the worst. No snap. So if he pumps that guy, it's like a 4-8. Alright, well, in that case, I'm bashing. Alright, I guess I take 8 here. Land would be pretty nice. Alright, hatching some plans and hopefully just dies to Lust for War. So if I make my Bramble Snap, well, either way, Bramble Snap's blocking that guy. The question is, do I want to block with another guy, too? You can just trade up Emrakul's Hatcher for that guy, if I want to. Yeah, it seems worth it. Eight damage? Yeah, it looks like enough. I mean, I could have traded Law of Fume Invoker, but I think the Invoker is a little bit more useful, though. I don't think either one is really getting activated. Alright. He can take my Vendetta. I suppose that is acceptable. Doesn't play anything else. This seems like a pretty sweet play. Alright, well, Lust for War did a lot of damage this match, and get to the finals with, I think, a kind of a miser deck, since pretty sure this deck is not that good.